Hey guys, welcome to, well, not really Belgian Beers for System Architects anymore. Yes, well, I had a wonderful idea a year ago to, to continue the beer seminar trend and IT terminology. Who's here in the seminar for the first time? Let me show your hands. Truck, you're not. Okay, so, so let's see, half the room has no idea what to expect, and the other half of the room will carry your bodies out. So, in short, I'm Frankie, I'm lots of groups, I'm a Belgian as a service.
Oh,
yes, that's it. I do stuff for work, I'm also a Smurf.
Oh.
Sorry. And there is a small disclaimer that our friendly net poet here asks me to give you every time. So that if somebody wants to back out, now is your chance. Who wants to leave? T101, you don't count. Yeah. So, as it's said on the initial slide, for system architects. There was stuff in the news a few weeks ago that made me change the entire subject of the seminar and adapt the team a bit. And I made Monks in Space. Because there is this thing, the Transiting Planets and Planetesimal Small Telescope, which is a pair of telescopes located in Chile and in Morocco, and they are controlled from Belgium. And okay, the Transiting Planets and Planetesimal Telescope, that's very interesting, and it's looking for small planets who are transiting stuff. Although, as it is a Belgian satellite, the name has a different meaning. And what happened is that the TRAPPIST telescope on star 2MASJ, whatever, which looks like your Visa card number, he found a star, and they called the star TRAPPIST-1, which they were going to look at, and then looking for planets which would pass around the star. And it seems that TRAPPIST-1 has 7 planets around it. Well, okay, I have a team for Monks in Space, and we can start doing this. And there are, 7 planets. Okay, so what's 7 planets? What would link to 7 planets? I realized, 7 planets is close enough to 8 TRAPPIST breweries. In Belgium and Holland. I declare that close enough to rent these suits. So, as this is going to be TRAPPIST-based, let's play a game, Professor Falcon. This is, oh, by the way, for those who are new, this is quite interactive, and I hope there's a microphone in the back which can get passed around if you have questions or something. But first of all, let's play a game. You can shout out and I will repeat your answers for the stream and for the people who are looking at the internet and going, what the schnitzel is this? So, let's play a game. Yes. So, of the first one, everyone is set? Okay, now, let's play a game. Come on, people, you're not... Cores.
A lopping pool,
No, we had La Pinculta in the first seminar and nobody recognized it.
Orval
is one.
Uh-huh.
La Trappe. Uh-huh, yeah, keep going. You're still in the Low Countries, go ahead. No, it's the, trust me, this is not Lindemans. So for now you have mentioned Westmalle, West Vlaanderen, Chimay, Orval. That's four out of more.
Can I mention Orval again?
No. No, you may not mention Orval again. So, there is Rochefort is one, okay. So, and now there is one more in Belgium. You've just seen the map.
Yes. Go back.
Achel, yes. Good. Now, there's four more. Well, no, three if you mentioned all the map, which you didn't. Stift means monastery.
Yeah,
Engelsaal.
Yeah.
The Austrian one. Okay, two more. Yeah. Don't Wikipedia it, I'm watching you. you have St. Joseph's Abbey in the US, and you have Tre Fontane, Three Fountains in Italy, near Rome. No, for science. So, I think Truck won this round.
Do I get more of all?
Yes, you get more of all. Okay. So, how is the first beer in the meantime going? Good? Now, we need to keep a tempo, because There's a playlist that we need to go through. I'll tell you in a second, or 120. So, what we're gonna do here is go through all the Trappist breweries which exist. Have you taste some of them not, because I decided to skip them, and go just see in which chaos we end up. As usual, the guys who have been here know this. So we'll start in Westmalle, and this is like a trend that you'll see with most of these monasteries and abbeys. They were founded in like 1600s, 1700s, and they did okay. They were closed during the French Revolution and were sold off to a private property until then somebody bought them back and donated the buildings again to the monks who would first start a priory, and then they would be granted the status of abbey by Pope and local church management. Westmalle has three beers. That's a double, a triple, and an extra. Your triple is 7%, triple 9.5, and the Westmalle is 5%. Now, Westmalle Extra is a Paters beer, or a monk beer. But this is intended for drinking usage by the monks themselves as an everyday beer, and usually, it's not really for sale on the big market, but you can get it at the Abbey or at a bar which is really linked to it, which is something that will quite often come back. What Westmalle did first was they did the double. We'll come back to the terminology later. And currently it's based on a recipe from 1926. Especially here in Westmalle, the monks themselves are not really involved anymore with brewing the beer. They have outside staff, because they also have other products, because not all the monasteries will do beer. And I shall now ask to Father T101 and Father PPC how we are with the second one. Here we go. Yeah, so if somebody feels that you can need to reset your taste buds, we have some water available. Oh, yes, and buckets for leftover beers, please don't piss in them. So the question is, which beer it is? So this was the first one was the Westmalle triple, and what you're getting now is the Westmalle extra was the first one, and this is the triple. So, what's the difference between them? So this one is better. Why? Is it more nutty?
I'd say so. The taste is a little bit more rich.
Well, yeah, it all says like double the alcohol in it, which is your favorite liquid.
Yeah.
So coming on to the and I've mentioned again, we are talking about Trappist here, Trappist there, Trappist everywhere, but what is a Trappist on its own, because a Trappist on its own is a protected name, and you will have Trappist beers and you will have Abbey beers. Trappist beers is linked to certain monks, and they have to have some features which have to match in order for a beer to be called a Trappist. Can somebody name these terms to me? We have an idea. Mr. Pope, I'm looking at you.
Just because of the fucking name, right?
Well, no. So the beer has to be made by the Trappist order of monks. It has to be made inside the monastery, and the money made from the beer may only be used to keep up the monastery or go to good causes. An abbey beer is another abbey of a different order, or they don't make their own beer, who sell the name of their monastery to a commercial brewer, and then they will put that on there. Excuse me? Leffe isn't even a monastery anymore. Leffen is a random village where they took the picture of the church and put it on the glass. That's Leffe. Leffe is from the Interbrew group, which also bought your Budweiser truck.
Are you trying to say that Leffe is not a quality beer?
Well, Leffe has, so jumping a bit off topic while a fraud of T101 continues with the beer. Leffe as such, there are multiple Leffes. Personally, the Leffe Blonde, you can forget. The darker ones, they're okay. It's all of personal taste. What Leffe has, and I've mentioned this in previous seminars, they're jumping on the IPA train. They're jumping on the crazy French taste beer. I think in France you can buy Leffe with honey, Leffe with cherries, and Leffe with something else. Even if you're dying from thirst, don't get them. I've tasted them, and they are beyond horrible. Well, yes, they're crazy. Yes. Yeah, but you're Dutch. I'm sorry. So, the comment was that it's so bad, it becomes good again. I raise you a Frans Bauer, okay? So there. Looking at production numbers now. This is, don't know the year, what all the different breweries are churning out. So, La Trappe, Chimay, Westmalle are in the lead with large production numbers. Then you have Orval in the middle, and then it really goes down really fast with Rochefort, Zundert, Vleteren, and then the smaller pack is Vleteren, St. Joseph, Achel, Engelsel, and Trefontaine all at the back. So these are hectoliters, you have to multiply it with times 100 and then times 3 to figure out the number of bottles that they can do every year.
Yeah, so it's yearly.
This is yearly production, yeah.
Is
so.
It's true that this West that they are not selling it anywhere.
West Vleteren is mostly sold at the monastery. We'll come back to that. I have many slides on West Vleteren. But then if you sorry, what? Some time ago. So indeed, La Trappe lost its Trappist license for a few years because they were brewing externally, but they have upgraded their brewery internally and are now back under the Trappist name. So yes, indeed. There are also some exceptions on this to which we will come back. Let's go with there. How are we with number three?
We're ready if people want some water.
Okay. Just, you know, pass the bottle. So, up to now, already any questions while you reset your taste buds? Speaky, come on, you have a question, I see it in your eyes.
Not yet?
Not yet? Why not?
No.
Let's wait for a sec for all the water to be done. And then you'll have to hurry the fuck up. Do I see a hand raised for a question?
No, I want water.
Oh, no, you're not allowed to make statements.
I'm so surprised that this Achel is so slow. There's a low amount of...
Yes, yes. Achel has a very low production and is actually not that commonly distributed. So, we're going to jump to Engelcel, Stief Engelcel, which is an abbey located in northern Austria, also founded in the Middle Ages, open and closed a few times, and basically the current version was started by monks who were thrown out of Germany after World War I. Place got closed down by the Gestapo in 1939. Some monks were executed, some were sent to the concentration camps, some ran away. And then after the war, one third came back and they filled up the remaining open positions by German monks who were in a monastery in Bosnia, and they were kicked out over there. And then quite recently, in 2012, they became the eighth producer of Trappist beer. Now, although it is a Trappist beer, it's not a Belgian beer. There is no need that a Trappist beer needs to be a Belgian style, double, quad, triple. You can basically do whatever you want, as long as you, brew it yourself, use the money for your own good.
So we can have finished Trappist beer.
If you have a finished Trappist order who can make its own beer inside its walls, and use it for the good of the monastery, then yes.
Is it okay that we know that in case of the church already? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Know where we're going to get.
So, and what's happening here is that in the last year you will have extra Trappist beers coming on the market, and then it's more or less they're really in it for the extra money, because they see that specialty beer sells, Trappist beer sells, and they're jumping on the market. Which is, when you look at the website from the Abbey, everything is like nice and German and small, and in huge letters, the brewery.
Hell yeah.
so you really don't miss it. So how is this angle cell? Any good? Exactly, nobody does.
I love it because it has a really deep memory. It's really rye-based, like really dark and sweet.
So it's rye-based and dark and sweet according to the Finns.
I bet this has 12% of alcohol.
No. Only 9.7. So you don't need to exaggerate. Like, is this 12%? No, it's not. It's 9.7. I don't really see your problem. Okay, don't all yell together because I have to repeat your question for the stream. Untapped says? It can, because actually their brews needed some time to stable out at a certain level. So the first one was stronger because they're only since 2012. So, and then with some test brews, they were only on the market pretty recently. And yes, the first brews were stronger, and then slowly it dropped. Also, they have a few beers and that they tried earlier, and that this Gregorius is the current one that they put on the market. I'm gonna jump over to the US now, to St. Joseph's Abbey. Pretty recent, they moved into an old farm building, and hi, hello, here. Thank you. And they became really recent, and they just felt, okay, we need extra funds for the Abbey, we're gonna make beer. So they went to the Belgian Beer Fest in Boston, they visited the breweries in Belgium and Holland, which were initially quite skeptical on getting them. But they said, okay, start with one beer for the first 5 years, start slowly, etc. I don't have St. Joseph with me, because I can, it is for sale in Belgium for €5 a bottle, if you want to.
€5.
Yes, well, no, for me, for us here, it's expensive.
As a Norwegian, I don't see the problem.
So let's make a deal that you hand me like €150 now, and next seminar I'll have St. Joseph's. No. Yeah, it's like, you know, beer. Herr Telol, are you ready with the next one to be distributed? Okay, I'll bullshit some more. So, as I've mentioned, the Trappist order, or as I say, the order of Cistercians of the strict observance who follow the rules of Saint Benedict. And one of the rules of Saint Benedict says, you're allowed to live by the work of your hands, which is interpreted as you're allowed to sell shit. And then all the Trappist monasteries, they will sell cheese and bread. There is in Italy, they sell stuff based on eucalyptus because it grows in their garden. U.S. Trappist monasteries, there are, we mentioned St. Joseph, but there are multiples. They will sell fruitcakes, for instance. So everything which is allowed to be commercialized. Those are the nuns. If you want those. So that's what a Trappist is. So not that we've done that, when I jump to the largest one in Belgium, which is Chimay, which is actually located in the village of Scourmont. Now, competition is to say Scourmont the way that you have to. I'm looking at the Finnish people now to say this in Finnish. Skuermund. Skuermund. Does Aki want to say something in the back? Yeah, so the Abbey of Chimay is pretty recent in its history, as it was created by monks from Westvleteren Abbey, to which we will come later. And then they made subdivisions in Wales and Belgian Congo and more or less around the world. Back in the days, they were a pretty successful monastery. And what they have in Chimay is 4 or 5 types of beer. You have your red, your blue, your triple, and your doré, and they have less cheeses as well. What you'll find quite often is the blue and the red one. Every now and then you have the gold. Although that again is more a part of beer, which is limited in availability to like monastery and close by. And as mentioned as well, so it's not only beer, Chimay also has like epic cheese. And yes, they have cheese made with Chimay beer, in case you were wondering. You need cheese? Sorry, wrong seminar. I'm looking at the colleagues in the back. They're almost ready. I'll wait a second for them. Okay. Next abbey we have is the one in Italy, Tre Fontane, Three Fountains. Truck. Hi. Hi. Hey. Hi. Here. Good. All right. So it's a collection of three churches, and it goes back to the 7th century. It actually changed orders a few times and became Cistercian and Trappist in the 17th century. And then with the combination of the Papal State and the unification of Italy, they got land and stuff. And as said, they are focused on eucalyptus. What they also do is that they herd sheep, and with those sheep, the wool, they make the official pope dressings and stuff, because that's what they do. Also, they're quite close to Vatican City, so you can actually drive the sheep up the road, and you're there, and that's where they are located. Yeah, chase. You can chase the sheep. So, next one being distributed is a Tre Fontane Triple. And this is one of the more recent additions, a few years. Lots of herbs and eucalyptus. Well, they what Tre Fontane does, they have large gardens of all kinds of trees, and they do not just beer and stuff. So they have honey, they have liqueurs, they have chocolate, and they have a eucalyptus liqueur even. Sorry, truck, what you're saying? I have no idea if it cures sore throats.
I think we should try.
Do you have a sore throat?
No, but it's not yet. As a person who suffers with allergies,
uh-huh,
and I use eucalyptus to cure that, I'm totally okay, if I can get beer,
uh-huh,
and drink that to cure, hello.
What?
Yeah, exactly. If I can get my
Uh-huh. Well, yeah, you should have to move to Belgium.
Or Italy.
No, Italy is not like beerish at the office. They have drink other things. Okay, so while this is distributed, any more questions or comments? Because you're really all sounding to get happy. No, but it's that there. It doesn't have to be from but there are many excellent non-Belgian beers. No, it's Monks in Space.
Frankie.
Yes, there's a question in the back. Okay. Yes, like you've been talking a lot. Now is the people in the back who get to say something. Are there eucalyptus trees in Belgium? Maybe in a garden somewhere. You could have what? Technically, I think as you have panda diplomacy, there should also be koala diplomacy. So it is possible. Maybe we have too much koalas that they eat all eucalyptus and that we don't get to make any beer with it. He's making a joke about what? Okay, they're making jokes in the back about things we don't know about.
Really hard to hear them over the bass.
Well, yeah, I'm talking about the bass in the intro music that we're hearing all day. LeGoober asked how low do the bass boxes go, and the reply was 45 hertz, and the answer was say no more.
Oh.
So if you're sitting down and you feel the floor moving, that's why. Well, no, so. Okay. Are we done with Tre Fontane?
I want more of this.
Well, maybe if there's some left at the end, we'll see. I got half a crate, and then we'll find out. Okay. Because also, this eucalyptus based beer has its opposition. That some people say it's not a Trappist. A Trappist has to be your double, triple, quad, and not this herb and not this herb thingy. And opinions differ, which is good.
Are those people called Belgium?
those people are usually called internet trolls. Question in the back?
No?
Oh, you are pointing at you. Okay, good. Okay. So, and we've mentioned them a while. So, what are the thing with, you know, the double, the triple, the quad? Because those are terms that will come back. And in short, but not entirely correct, because of exceptions. It's the number of fermentations that the beer has had.
What?
A double will have two, a triple will have three, a quadruple four, and the last fermentation is in the bottle. If you're looking at a beer with a single fermentation, so a solo, that's usually called a blonde beer. If you have like a blonde Trappist, you will have your single fermentation, you have double, triple, quad. A last fermentation is in the bottle. So when bottling the beer, they will put extra yeast, extra sugar in the bottle, and it will re-ferment a final time in the bottle, which can leave some yeast residue, which is safe to drink. Not everybody drinks it. And what homebrew enthusiasts do is that they quite often get the yeast out of the bottles and then cultivate it so that they are, for instance, making their own beer with the yeast of a Westvleteren or a Chimay or something else.
Really stupid question.
Toren has a stupid question.
How do you start and end for fermentation?
How you start and end fermentation? The yeast bacteria need food, they need sugar. So you can measure that. And also, above a certain level of alcohol, they will no longer reproduce and they will die off. So by looking at the alcohol levels and the sugar levels and which yeast bacteria that you take, you can get them to ferment a bit more, yes or no.
So when you reach the like double or triple fermentation end, and
yes,
the yeast dies,
yes,
how can you start to port like
you so after your fermentation cycle ends, you filter the beer, so you have all the yeast residue, it goes out. And then you re-add sugar and you re-add yeast, which is why triples and quads are usually sweeter because there's a lot more sugar has been used to produce them, which also makes you not taste the alcohol.
That's so good. The monks are very good at that.
Of course the monks are very good. You know, they've been doing it since like the Middle Ages. No, there is no alcohol here, of course not. Truck weight, yes?
We can collect the yeast.
Yes?
And you can grow it. It is not a dead.
Well, can you get the yeast from the rest of a bottle? It depends. You know, most of the yeast will be dead, no longer active. There might some still be alive. And then, because it will go into a lower alcohol environment, it can grow again. And then you can have your culture, and you'll have hobbyists who will, you know, get the yeast from Eschimé, Ebersleteren, Aleffe, whatever, to use in their own brews. It's not always successful, but you know that's your access, and you can get lucky that something has survived, and that you can use it.
Are those monasteries using their own yeast, or are they using commercially available yeast?
Are the monasteries using their own yeast or commercially available? A bit of both. You will have the bigger ones, like Eschimé, will have developed their own yeast over the years. And sometimes they also hand them over to other breweries. There is, for instance, a brewery, Mondeca, which we will get to later, which is brewed at the Eschimé breweries. So also, therefore, also uses the same yeast. Pieter, kunnen we met de volgende? Okay, doe maar. So, going back to the quadruple, there is some discussion to what a quad really is, except for a silly motorcycle, which, you know, gets air jumps. There is discussion if a quad or a quadruple is in its own a beer. As what you also, because it's quite often, I have to make some room here for the guys. I'll tell you which one this is later. Not at all, truck, what?
I said it before it was.
Oh.
Is this fruity?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, no. This is not a strong one. Well, you know, compared to the average. Well, no. So, Grand Cru, except, you know, making games, is also a beer name or a type of beer, and the Cote de Grand Cru is quite often compared. Yes, a Grand Cru will also be lots of fermentations, and it's more or less like the top of the line of the beer. You will have, for instance, a Hougard de Grand Cru is also a blend of multiple beers together. You have several years that they mix together into a Grand Cru. You have a Cuvée René Grand Cru from Lindemans, Jeus en Kriek, which is really a mixture of sometimes 5-6 years of beers mixed together. And I think, Truck, we had one in Helsinki once, a Cuvée René Kriek, which was quite awesome.
Yeah. Was it the... Never mind. Nobody else was going there.
No.
Come to Helsinki, we have beer.
Yes.
Beer capital of Helsinki.
Yes. Love and culture for the masses. Now, what you have now, this is that, like, quite often the term quad or quadruple is being misused as marketing because they wanna you have your quadruple Belgian ale, you'll have your quadruple IPA, you have your quadruple whatever, just like this is a lot of it. This is the best of the range, which quite often isn't so, because a quadruple is extremely heavy, extremely sweet, and the sugar takes away a lot of the taste if you're not careful.
So, are they using quadruple as a fake term that they are not doing?
As a what, sorry?
I mean, are they using quadruple in a term like fake name that they are not using?
Well, it's not a fake name, but it is like, a quadruple does not indicate that is the best of the series anymore.
Yeah, but I mean that not all quadruples are for fermentation.
Yes. All quadruple means for fermentations.
Yeah, but they are not using it. That's necessarily not done for fermentations. Even they are doing...
No. A quadruple will always have for fermentations. Someone was waving in the back.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, we'll get to that.
Yeah, okay. So, yeah.
Sure. Yeah, yeah. Koningshoeve komt nog.
Yeah, sure. That's fine.
Yep, top. So,
what was this?
This was a Rochefort.
Who?
It is also.
But not then.
Yeah, this is.
No, it's not.
Yeah, this is six, yes?
It could be.
Right.
Well, it's easy. But you know, Rochefort has like 6, 8, and 10, so your time is limited.
I'm thinking it's, you know, I still have my 6.
Okay, so we'll quickly run through this. Guys, hi, hello. I know you're happy, but you have to be happier in a bit.
If I don't get my Orval because you guys are making noise, there will be a very unhappy truck.
Truck, the more noise you make, the longer you're going to have to wait for your Orval. And you already had some sweet Orval yesterday. So, the Rochefort Abbey, bit the same story. Started in the Middle Ages, closed in the French Revolution, and then when everything was mostly destroyed, the monastery of Achel bought the land remaining and restored the buildings, and in its current form started with the beer in 1952. I'll have a look how we are in the rest, they're still going. So, as said, Rochefort has three beers, the 6th at 7.5, simple, 8 at 9.2, and the 10 at 11.3 alcohol. And they're, well, Rochefort 8 is a bit of a special one, as it was intended to be a one-time thing for New Year. But of course, when things sell good and there is demand, you start putting them on the market for more, and it becomes a global availability. As with also with many Trappists, you can see at the bottle of the cap, because they will quite often not be labeled. Yeah, the cap, the color is indicates the beer. So as we have seen with Chimette, they use colors for the blue and red. It's also a red, green, and blue here. While there is no set standard in that, say, a red cap is 6 and a green one is 8, that doesn't go. For instance, Westleteren 12 has a yellow cap, for instance.
This
was 6, as Truck said. T101, are we ready for the next one?
Yeah.
Okay.
So why the mugs are so bad with math? So 6 is
7. No, I don't.
Tricky. What question?
Here. Give me your glass. Why are you drinking like from a champagne glass?
Well, it's good to belong together.
You snob.
Frankie?
Hi. I have to watch out for the speakers or you'll be deaf. There you go. Ask the bottles from the guys in the back.
Frankie?
Yes?
Last year, what was it?
Okay, sorry, truck is mumbling, I can't hear you.
I'm not talking.
What was the last beer we got?
The last one was the Rochefort 6. What you're getting now is the 8. That's most likely, you know, it's going to be like a double, triple, quad if you look at the levels of alcohol. You have to see, like, you start out at 5-6%, and each re-fermentation will add like 2-3% in alcohol level. So you can more or less count how that goes. Now,
this is more tasty.
Yeah.
Even though the last one was strong, it felt like really warm.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So, what I want to come now here to is, you have the 3 Rochefort, you had the 6 and the 8. But, and I know we're doing cups, but this is a Belgian thing. With the beer, you need the proper glass.
Is this the proper glass?
No, it's not. Absolutely not.
And it does matter.
It does totally matter.
So, because it's a slight difference. If you just, you know, look at this.
No, not good.
This is like this would be like the, oh, Americans drink beer.
No, it's a red cup.
Yes.
Yeah. So, this is, it's, presentation is everything. And the glass will also serve the beer. So if you have a large foamy head, the glass will allow it. If the beer is to be served with not a lot of foam, the glass will be wider in the chalice. Quite often fruit beers will have the longer glasses. But it's a bit of a style. And yes, every single beer, every own brewery has its own glass. And it is not uncommon in Belgium in the bar when they give you beer in the wrong glass that you send it back. It is that important.
But do they do that mistake?
Yes, sometimes they do. That they will give you a double in a leffe glass and then you send it back.
And if you don't get your guac in a proper glass, that's fine.
How many glasses do you have?
Well, you have at least one for every brewery and mostly one for every beer. So a lot.
So how large is your glass cabinet right now?
My glass cabinet is sizable.
Do you have glass for quack?
Do I have a glass for quack? Well, no, because I don't like quack myself. But now that you have mentioned quack, the glass is important.
Do you get a drink from our penis aquafit?
So, and yes, this glass is more or less marketing, but it is also it's a nice gimmick.
It's good beer.
So, you know, a quack you take by the handle, and you drink the beer like using a big mug. The cornet or the horn you grab with your hands or whichever method you try. Also, the name quack and the glass comes from the fact if you drink the beer in one go and you break the vacuum of the ball in the middle, all the beer will flow in your face. Hence the name quack. It's quite urban legendy, but I like the explanation. Because, you know, scientifically it makes sense. So, how was your Rochefort 8 compared to your 6?
Way better?
Okay, so, who says 8 was better than 6?
Oh, there you go.
that doesn't even have. So the first row, yes, but the rest doesn't. It must be a Finnish thing.
I'm never going to turn down either one.
I don't care if you don't finish. Close enough.
I can't tell. I don't have the right glass.
We have a wise ass in the back, haven't we? Stay here. So, next one is Achel, the one that nobody guessed. And this is what I would call a Belgian compromise. A Belgian compromise is a thing mostly known from politics that it's a solution where nobody is happy. But you're not happy, but the other guy isn't happy as well. So what they did after the 80-year war in the late 17th century, in what was then Holland, you were no longer allowed to have Catholic mass. So they moved.
15th century, please.
So what they did, they moved 50 meters across the border into Belgium and started praying there, making an abbey, started making beer, and ended up with a new system in 98 with the help from the Trappists from Westmalle and Rochefort. How are we on the Achel readiness?
2:01?
2 minutes? Good. So, I'll show you where Achel is on its own. So, this is the Netherlands. This is Belgium, and it's right on the border. And when I mean right on the border, it is right on the border.
That's crazy.
How many times have you been to Belgium to do that?
So this is your, they could go to their mass and they could have their prayer, and they were not in Kingdom of the Republic of the Netherlands, but they were in whatever Belgium there was, because Belgium didn't exist.
So they have a Belgian citizen.
The Abbey of Achel is Belgian.
Okay.
It's in Belgium, just.
And so the door entrance is in Belgium.
Well, so it's actually the location of the front door that counts. If you, there is a Belgian enclave in the Netherlands, and it's like 10 pieces of Belgium in the Netherlands, and of those pieces of Belgium, you have pieces of the Netherlands again.
So is it the reality that the Netherlands people take whatever the crazy Belgium do?
The Netherlands people take whatever they want. Sorry, what?
We can get this beer from all of Finland.
Yeah.
But we cannot get the rest of the beer. But we have one wine. Mm-hmm. This guy actually goes to the fridge.
So.
Is there a typo there?
Sorry?
Is there a typo there?
Why?
Is one of the extra ones from? Yes.
It might be.
Yes.
Otherwise, it's wrong twice.
Yes. Well, no, they just make twice as much of it. Yeah. So, Achel, or the Achelse Klaas, the vault from Achel. They have basically two types of beer, and they have them in a 5 and 8, and a 9.5% variety. While the 5% are on tap at the Abbey and at the bars next to it. The extra blonde is sold only at the Abbey itself. What you're getting now, what you have now, is the blonde one. And but the thing is with Achel, you can, its distribution is limited. So in Belgium, I can find it near my place because it's relatively close to where I live. I'm waving back to the guy in the back, by the way, so just ignore him. Thank you.
Fuck you.
No, thank you. You didn't shave this morning.
I did, actually. But yeah, best way.
So,
I found it number 4.
Anyway,
in the Netherlands as well.
You're disturbing the peace, my man, so in the front.
Is this number 5? Yes, but that's because I am the
5. This is the Achel Blonde, sir, and is the 8, because the 5 you can only get at the monastery, the 8 you can get in the stores.
It says out of production
For the what? Well, no, it's not out of production, but it's like only made locally in most, and they don't make it quite that much. They like make a batch and then it goes through the year. So out of production, not really, but extremely low. So, and then in general, as you've noticed on the production list, that Achel on its own has a very low production amount, and then most of it is exported to Finland and other countries. Why? Because they can get more money for it over here.
Yes, yes. And they're smart ass Norwegians which can get this also.
Well, Norwegians can get everything except a deal with the EU on fisheries. I'm sorry.
Fucking salmon.
That was actually painful.
So, anyway.
Like, not getting a deal with the EU. The EU has been asking.
You're not going to. This is.
Referendums.
We'll buy your oil.
Blah, blah. So. You will. So what you will now have is the blonde. The brown one will follow as the next one. So when that's ready, that can come out. And in the meantime, I'm going to jump to a question that, you know, people ask me, like, where do I get these seminar beers? Because, you know, it's a collection. And for truth is, I just go to the store around the corner.
No, dude, you don't even know.
Yeah, so Truck has been there. I think MBB as well. It's more or less this like 4 or 5 times just stacked with crates everywhere. And as said, a 5 euro beer is expensive.
It's nice.
And if you look at the Trappist, there are in the corner here is your Engelstel and your Trefontane. This is Chimay. A bit Chimay. This is more Chimay on the side. A bit of Achel. La Trappe. And then a random guy who was looking at the whiskey section. No, this is definitely not Alco.
Yeah, but we have Achel in Alco.
Yes, well, no, as said, a lot of the production is exported because they can get a better price from it. It's only because Achel is like really close to this store that their buyer can every now and then get a few pallets of it, because you see, compared to say a La Trappe or a Chimay, you have, you know, 8 crates over there, which, you know, and I took one of them.
Monopolies make a lot of money.
Sorry, what money?
Monopolies make a lot of money.
It's not a monopoly. It's supply and demand, and the demand in say the U.S. is far greater than in Belgium, so they can just get more money from it. You know, a simplest example is for Estella Artois. When you get that in Belgium in a bar, it's 2 euro to €2.50. For exactly the same beer, exactly in bit of a fancier glass, you can sell that in London for £9 to £10. Same beer, same production line, you only need like a big truck to take a boat and drive there and Two stuff.
And I'm totally will do it too.
So. There we are. Do we need 2 minutes on the brown T101? Are we good?
1 minute.
1 minute? Good. So I have one more slide for 1 minute, which is the rest of the store.
I had trouble leaving the place without spending like way too much fucking money. We did anyway because fucking.
So, okay, wait, no, yeah. Never mind. So, for instance, we have here has the Rochefort and the Westmalle. Pascal, inderdaad, wel heel het.
Throwing away beer? Oh, wait. Who's throwing away beer?
Nobody.
Oh, here we go. Cheers! Stop doing that.
Drunk, I have a question for Frankie. Is these two slides like grabbing it?
No, yeah. Well, you can see in the distance that here's an entire wreck of Delirium Tremens. You can see the pink elephant. This is a stack of pollen.
I wait when you get to the West for the rare, because in Helsinki you can buy one bottle for 20 euros.
20 euros? Okay. I get a crate for 20 euros. So. How is this, before we continue here, how is your Akel Blonde compared to your Akel Bruin, which you have now? This is Akel Brown one. This is the brown one, Akel. Brown. They're similar.
I like the blonde one.
You like the blonde? Okay, so looking at Akel, those who already have it, who likes the first one better, the blonde one?
This is the brown.
Now you're having brown.
Previous
one was blonde. So who likes the first one but the blonde one better? That's about 20% of the people.
I like this better. I'll drink this in the winter and the blonde in the summer.
Fair enough. So yeah, so what Truck says, your darker ones are a winter beer or that you drink when you're looking a cycling thing like the Tour of Flanders or Paris-Roubaix, which we won again. The blonde one is more for summer drinking, a brown one is what you like slowly drink over the course of 30, 40 minutes and then take the next one. So. So, looking at here is a small cardboard row of the American Spencer Trappist, followed by the Trappist from Zundert, which we will get to. I'll give a while for the water to be passed around. A question? Yes?
Yeah. If some of these marks decided for some reason to make something.
Hang on, guys. There is somebody ask a question. Can you give me the microphone? Perhaps I can't really hear him. Pump, pump, pump. Audio, guys, microphone, please.
Some of these monks decided to make something like an IPA.
Yes.
Would that still be considered a Trappist beer?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, because it's not what the ingredients are that defines a Trappist. A Trappist is brewed by who, where, for what. Which is why I set the Italian one can have more herbs and eucalyptus, while your traditional Belgian ones will be your triples and doubles and quads. So, you know, you can, technically, a Trappist monastery can make an IPA. Sorry, Ian?
You talked about that West Mal has outsourced his production, so it's...
well, yes and no. They just extended the monastery to include the brewery. It's a budget compromise. So no, but also, as I said, West Mal, they're it's yeah for the big production, and they also have like, you know, different types as well as, you know, cheese and blah. So truck, hi.
I'm very sorry.
Yes, you are.
We are getting happy.
Oh, now you're getting happy. It hasn't even started yet. Woo! So, and of course, when we've looked at all these trappists, which ones are missing?
Yo!
West Vlaanderen and?
Orval!
Zundert we have. Orval. Which is a cave, which is a question. So, how the hell do you get Orval?
can you translate that, please?
Holy shit!
This is a picture I put. I backtracked. So in preparation, I went to my local little like supermarket, which has, as every Belgian store, a bit of a beer selection. Suddenly, I saw two crates for Val. You take them with you. because you cannot get it in bars, but very, very unlikely in stores. So, next day I came back because I needed a new bread. I saw two more crates of Orval. So you take them.
This country sucks.
Last week I was there and there were three crates of Orval.
And
I left them.
No!
I'm not greedy.
You're a kind person.
I'm a kind person. And this is, I posted this on my Facebook, it just said score. And these are Belgians that say, where the hell did you find the crate, let alone two?
And you answered?
And I answered, local supermarket. Where the other Belgian said, I have mine shipped in from Luxembourg. So, yes, yoink. So, literally, the local supermarket franchise, the crates were there for a week, others had their chance, yoink.
And what's the answer there on the last one?
I have a mic.
That's holy crap, I'm letting mine ring by colleagues who go to Luxembourg. It's easier to get it in Luxembourg than locally. Which is true. I have been in deli stores in New York with crates and crates of Orval for sale at inflated prices.
Yeah.
So the majority of Orval is actually or for bars and restaurants or for export. But like if I go to this store, I am allowed to buy six bottles of Orval.
Oh, secret, secret.
Secret, what?
In Finland, in Alko, you can buy Orval. I didn't know.
Of course you can.
You can get Orval down the street.
I didn't know.
You can get it everywhere, except in Belgium.
I didn't know that it's special beer.
Yeah, it's
second. I don't
believe you.
Excuse me, truck, yes?
10 seconds.
10 seconds for what? Never give Truck a microphone.
I can get Orval at the bar that is a half block from my place, and then there's another one a half kilometer away. So we can get it, but he can't.
No. I just
did. I know you can. I know. But
okay. And then.
I'm done.
You're done? Okay, so also now you can get it, This is 20 euro a crate.
No, exactly. I pay out the ass, but
I will. Not want to know what you pay out of the ass.
I don't want to subtract the pay out of the ass. All the money.
So, okay. All right. So. And then, so this is like an Abbey beer, which many people mistake for a Trappist. Why? Because it has a picture of a church on the glass. And it is an actual village, an actual church, but it is actually owned by the guys from Carlsberg Heineken. And then I already mentioned there is Mont des Cats, which is called a Trappist beer, but does not have the official Trappist label, because it is made for a Trappist monastery, in a Trappist monastery, but a different one. So, see, confusing? Good. No, it is a real Trappist. It is made in the brewery of Chimay for a monastery just in France. But because they're not brewing it themselves, it does not get the official sticker. Although, because they are a member of the Trappist order, they are allowed to call it a Trappist while it isn't, but it is. Yes, I can explain quantum theory next, but then, you know, if I explain it to you, it'll change the result. So I'm sorry, I cannot do that. So, okay, I think people seem to like this one suddenly in the first row.
It just smells of happiness.
Now, also, and you know, getting the beer, if that fails, you have a plan B in Belgium.
Oh, alcohol. I bet this is alcohol in.
This is 94% drinkable alcohol that you get in the supermarket on the shelf. So, see, so worst case, we get like a silly beer and we spice it up. Now, I've always been talking to the first row. I want to hear people in the second row. Or beyond. So, yeah, I want to hear like the people in the middle, because they're like the silent majority.
Is there a Trappist waffle beer?
First of all, why, and second, no.
Hang on, I have another question. Why the fuck do I have two full glasses? Where is everybody?
What the?
So, okay, now, which, so, this one, what's your feedback on the current beer which was distributed? It's bad, it's good, it's excellent, it's meh.
It's horrible.
It's okay.
Why is it horrible?
It tastes like shit, it's very bitter, but it makes you drunk good.
It's not bitter.
Okay. Chuck, I think they don't really disagree with you.
Damn straight I would.
Go ahead.
This is the best shit ever.
No, it's not.
No, that's true. It's not. It's not the arrogant bastard.
Fuck you, Chuck.
Arrogant bastard is your favorite beer?
Yes. Actually, I
won't ever talk to you
Bastard in cans, and I ordered a 24 pack, but then the postal service dropped it. I don't have it with me. You have no look. You're Norwegian. You have to have it. So the Urval Brewery goes back to the 10th century. Again, burned down in various revolutions, and rebuilt in 1935. If somebody still cares, there's a pattern here.
Yeah. No.
So the beer itself is from 1931, and as is this one, this is a young Urval. Urval is a kind of beer that you can quite easily store for 5-6 years, and its taste and its, you know, everything will improve and then flatten out after 5-6 years. So, hi.
You're not
just that you
didn't. We're being quiet.
Oh, ideally you have Urval in a semi-cold dark room for a few years, and there will be definitely an improvement in the taste. But when you go to a bar, you get the young one, you don't get that improvement. If you want, for say, in a bar, an Urval from 2 or 3 years old, you will pay a 5-6 euro premium really, really easy. Just for them holding on to the crate for a few years. There is a variety called the Petit Urval, which is drunk by the monks themselves, and is not generally for sale, but you can get it at the Abbey should you want to.
So if you go to a pub in Belgium, can you ask for the old ones?
Some do, some don't. So the question is, can you get the older ones? Some bars actually keep a stash, but they will sell it to you at a large premium. But yes, you can go to like specialist beer bars, and they will have, say, 2, 3, 4, 5 years old, and per year you can add 3-4 euros in. So after we have done our vault, we go to Maria Toevlucht, or Zunder.
I've never heard of this.
Who started making their beer in 2013 after they could no longer have a farm on the land because they were doing milk and meat production, but very likely hygienic laws changed and they had to close, so they moved to beer production. That's German beer, that's fine. So that's. I'll have a look in the back of how we are on number 10 already. 2 minutes. So, until now, are there any other questions while you still have active brains to ask them?
Is there more of all?
Maybe.
Okay. So where is this beer? From which country?
This is in the Netherlands.
Okay. I have never heard of this company.
Yeah, it's one of the smaller ones, and they're also pretty recent, so 2013. If you were here in the first beer seminar, you would have tasted one. Behind the truck, I don't know your name.
Just a quick question, was this beer meant to taste sour?
Ish, yes. Okay. Urval is not a sweet beer. It has an aroma and a taste that, it tends to be a bit of an acquired taste, I admit.
Thank you.
Yeah. Other question on the same row somewhere I saw a hand? No? Come on, was someone doing a question? I feel ignored.
You're not ignored.
So who is Maria Toevlucht?
A Toevlucht is like a refuge. So the Abbey of the Refuge of Maria. No. But then it's in the village of Zunder. So you will very often you have The name of the abbey is not what they market the beer. So as with Clermont and Chimay, they will have the abbey will have its like official long name, while they will market the beer under the local village or town.
How can you call this authentic?
How can you call it authentic? Because what's wrong?
It's so young.
Well, no, it's because it is made by Trappist monks at the monastery at the abbey for, you know, paying costs at the abbey. And they started recently, so they got the official stamp, and then they went.
Okay, there was just pause for 4 years.
No, they wind it down and they have to take down the stables, build the brewery, and that takes a few time, you know, to design. And when you have your brewery, you have to make some test brews to see that everything works, and then it takes 3-4 years before you're ready to go to market, and that's your gap. So, and as we already mentioned, so, Koning Schumann, or sorry, what? Schumann, what? Okay, sorry, you're making no sense.
It's half Finnish, half English, it's
still. Exactly. Hoover is a farm. Yes, Koning Hoover, like at the king's farm. It now makes sense.
Yes.
I know that Finland is not a monarchy, but we tend to have kings and queens.
We have
No, you haven't.
We have Kekkonen.
Yes. Yes. But that's like a dead president.
No, he was king.
Yes. I can't hear you.
Didn't you say that the previous beer was going to get served?
They're serving the next one.
Yeah, is this the previous one?
This is a Latvia. The previous one was a Valle.
So we are not getting the previous one.
No, you've had your Valle. That was number 9.
Right, yes,
this is number 10.
We were looking
for the previous slide.
No. Sundet is not, as I said, you had it before.
Right, in the first seminar.
Exactly. So this is not, right now, not included.
Okay.
So, Latvia was actually founded by the monks from Mont des Cats, which are in the difficult situation, and started brewing beer in the 1880s.
Thank you.
Yes.
Do you consider that Belgians are happy people?
Well, let's say there is a documentary on Belgian dance music, which is called The Sound of Belgium, which I can recommend to you. And it actually describes as people who work hard and party harder. Well, yes, there is some kind of happiness, you know. If you would live in Belgium, you would stop giving fucks about politics, and you know. So if there is, and this is.
Oh, is that my problem?
This is a quote from a comedian called Nigel Williams, said that if there is like a war going on or something needs to be bombed. And they said, yes, we need support from our allies. Belgium says, you go ahead, we're finishing our beer, but we'll be right there. Which is mostly what we do.
Yeah, the thing is, you're gonna fucking be there.
So yes, breakpoint your question. This is a Latra. There is no Zundert here today. So, La Trappe has quite a number of beers. Again, you have the Blonde, which is your single. A Double, a Triple, an Isidore, which is a special beer that they made for our anniversary and kept in production. A Quadruple, Quadruple on oak barrels. A white beer, a Bock beer, and Pure or Pure, which is all natural. No, Pure.
What is this one?
This one is
for this is Isidore.
Do you have one? Thank you.
So, as said, this was launched, this was made for the 125th anniversary of the brewery, the Abbey, and they named it after Isidorius, which was their first, in a second, brewmaster. And it was a one-off, but, you know, it sold, so they kept it in the lineup. And looking for the seminar at a very low 7.5%.
How dare you?
Well, that explains a lot.
Well, yes, it explains everything.
So,
what's your feedback on Isidore?
So, right.
Good. In the back? You're holding up a camera, I can see what it is.
So,
yep, top.
Very good.
Very good. Isidore is approved.
So, what was this beer produced in Middle Earth?
You would have to ask Peter Jackson.
Oh, you're gonna be pissed. You are.
Why am I pissed?
Where is this from? Where is this from?
What?
What country is this from?
Trump is in Holland.
Okay, because it does say Holland.
Mm-hmm. So while the name of the beer is French, La Trappe, it is located in the Netherlands, and the Abbey is called Koningshoven. It's all marketing.
So you're basically saying that everybody is screwing everybody in Europe.
Of course, Carl.
Yes.
What do you
mean? There's a microphone coming.
Are you going to wear the hood?
No.
And why not?
It'll mess up the haircut.
Like mine.
Yes. You know, this is all like very, very aesthetic, dangerous thing. We actually, while unpacking the 114-101, we had like such a lightning bolt come off. Because it's all synthetic material. Oh, but actually really good. So, yes. I'm gonna look at the back. This is the number 11? Okay. So we've had Isidore. Okay, so this is the La Trappe Quad at 10%, four fermentations, and set to be the first quadruple in the world. Should you care? No. There are now gazillions of quadruples, but again, as a quadruple, it'll be quite dark, quite heavy, quite sweet.
It's heavy.
Yes.
It's strong.
And sweet, yes. Because it has like four loads of sugar in it.
Like this.
Yes. A beer like this is called a liquid lunch. If you're watching, you know, your calorie intake, one bottle is like 300 calories. What could go wrong? Okay. Scamp, how are you doing? You've been silent all the time. My. So you're all completely wasted, and we still need to have the finale.
We are not completely wasted. We are 75% wasted.
Yes, you are, because you can take
it.
Why does this beer taste so good?
Because it has a ton of sugar in it, and your brain says, feed me more.
Thank you.
A rational answer. Yes.
So, which one have we missed until now?
Westvleteren.
Aha!
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 Okay, the Finns in the first row are getting aggressive.
We just like Westerland.
Yes, you do. So, the St. Sixtus Abbey was founded in the 1200s, and that's some history. Almost destroyed in World War One, World War Two, and just to imagine where it's. This is in Westvleteren. Is a tiny village.
It's literally Florida.
Near the French border. So this is 2 hours drive from Brussels.
Far away.
That's far away. You can cross the country.
In Belgium
it's 2 hour drive is, I know in Norway that's your driveway, but you know.
How do you do it? 2 hours.
you have to have a sandwich.
So, and now, as you said, that you mentioned that it is impossible to order, to get. This is a procedure. The Abbey has a hotline that you can call. Per call, if you get through, you can order 2 crates. Depending on what day you call, you can order kinds of beer on that day. Next slide will make it clear.
What is your first?
If you order 2 crates, you have to give the license plate of your car, and that car is not allowed to come back for 2 months.
Get a render call.
Also, the phone number that you use will be blocked for 2 months.
Get a prepaid.
That's actually what people do. Let me, guys. This is yesterday's page, which says that on the 11th and the 12th, you can call between 8 and 10 and 8 and 12 to order 2 crates of Westvleteren 12. If you get through to the call center on that day, you are allowed to order 2 crates of Westvleteren 12. These are the pickup dates, which are full, you can ignore. But if you get through and you say, I would like 2 crates, they will say, this day, that time, show up, click.
No soup for you,
Olsen.
Yeah. No Westvleteren for you.
Real man.
So that makes it, there, and the monks are really, really strict to that. So they could sell more, but then they do.
Well,
every now and then.
Yeah.
Okay.
They're on the best.
Although they have made these building blocks when they had to renew an entire roof of the monastery. They make a one-time deal to brew extra and make a nice box, and I put it on the market.
Is that your official model for that?
Tuesday.
This is the special pack bottle with the Citroen 12 on it. Usually it's, you know,
it's just
the bottle.
Yeah.
Now, I'll tell you about the crazy prices. This is eBay yesterday.
What?
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 So 20 euros for a bottle is nothing.
Nice.
Cheap.
Still cheap for Norway.
So this is a special collector's building brick. This gift pack is what you can buy in the bar across the street.
In Norway you get one barrel of oil.
Norway doesn't count.
In Norway you get one barrel of oil and you get one bottle of beer.
Yes.
That's almost like 32 euros for like shipping works out.
Because this is from the US. For instance. So now look at if you're looking at more or less 10 euro per bottle. Children? You're looking at more or less 10 euro per bottle. If you look at what you pay at the Abbey, it's more or less 2 euro per bottle plus some deposit. These are the official retail prices, and by buying it, you actually make a contract with the monks not to resell it. So nobody cares, but that's what it is. Let's see how colleagues are doing the back. So two more minutes for the next beer.
What is the next beer? It's Westfalen.
It's next beer.
How do you pronounce it?
Westfalen.
Westfalen. Westfalen.
Westfalen.
Holy crap, dude! You're worse than me.
I'm finished.
Yeah, seriously. Westfalen.
Yeah. So, for instance, so to driving there. You have to show up at the time that they say to pick up your beer. Now to get there, it's such a small road, many settlers don't know it. You're driving on a small rural road, there's a small sign that says Sinsictus up there, Abbey where it is, and you just, it's a small road, one car wide, that disappears into the field. And behind the horizon you have the park and the Abbey, and that's where it is. Now, this beer got like really famous with the internet like 10 years ago, and suddenly everybody wanted it. Now, we have been drinking Westfalen in Belgium since forever. It was a thing, you went on vacation at the coast, and you drove over there in the afternoon, you took your two crates and you went off.
Yeah, my friends had to wait until the second weekend to get through it.
And then I want to hit the
list. Yes?
Has had their next one.
How did you get that this?
I know my people.
So you didn't go there.
Hang on, 10-4.
Is it against any Belgian laws to serve Westfalen in a plastic cup?
It should be. So is it forbidden? Is it illegal to give it in a plastic cup? It should be. Yes. No, you have fed the apples. We are done with the apples. Does everybody have the new beer?
Not yet.
Not yet? Okay, I'll wait for a second.
These people say that it's creamy. It's creamy.
Yes. It's really thick. It's a quadruple and really, really thick, really, really creamy indeed.
Actually, I have one like doctor
Okay.
And I bought this for him.
Yes.
And I ordered like 4 centiliters.
Uh huh.
Tasted, and he said, "This is good beer." And I just told him, "You have a good taste."
Uh huh.
I can understand why you don't like Finnish rubbing food, but
well, nobody does.
Yeah.
Except
I do. But you like this.
You're strange.
But like he's good taste.
Yes. Okay. Let's see that the last guys get their the latest one. So, is there a stupid question? Is everybody happy?
Yes.
Excellent. Okay. Is everybody set? Cheers and cheers in the middle. Have a taste. So, as before mentioned, pouring Westvleteren and from a plastic cup is illegal. So this is St. Bernardus of 12. Which is basically the same as Westvleteren but from a different brewery. The story here is that the brewery is next to the Abbey, but and they brewed the beer for the Abbey for many, many years. This contract ended in 92, and with the same recipe, they continue to make this. So this is basically your white label Westvleteren 12. This is one of the. This is a pretty good kept secret. It is not the same. They have the Westvleteren today uses a different yeast. They use different groundwater because even their clothes is different water. But more or less, it's in a blind tasting. Not many people can keep them apart.
I heard this Martin Lindbom.
It's not so. Maybe. So now. Talking about the Westvleteren, they have again the cap with your 6, your 8, and your 12 that you can get if you are lucky.
But the last bottle with branding is the one that they sold.
Yeah, the last one is from the gift box.
Yes.
Normally, see, like this. It's a bottle without a label on it.
Hey, you have the magic. You are my best friend.
Ta-da! Now, because you're all drunk as hell, I'm not going to serve this today. Because you need to be able to appreciate it and not drink it from a bloody plastic cup.
I'm so fat that I can.
So, this will be around if you're nice. These are, if you want one, I will. You can get one at cost from the brewery.
I'm
not making any money on this.
I will pay you anything.
I want your first
one. Well, the Norwegian will pay. You do not want your first one.
So, anyway. We have now had all the Trappist Abbeys. If you're doing Untapped, you can add me. If you want a list of what you have been drinking today, here it is. Woo. And for me, that's it.
Do we get the last beer?
That's what you have.
Bathroom.
Well, the bathroom is below here, but we need to go through the tunnel. party, get the fuck out. And we'll fill up in here and we'll come out later. If you have any questions, you can talk to me then. Also, then, thank you for attending. Maybe I'll do this again next year.